I will tell you how to recover or store air conditioner refrigerant back into the compressor and then remove both the indoor and outdoor units. I will also tell you how to recover the refrigerant without using the gauge if you don't have one. Pumping down the air conditioner to recover refrigerant in winter is a little challenge because many outdoor unit compressors do not start in cool mode due to low ambient temperatures. I will also tell you how to start the unit in winter in cool mode to store the refrigerant. I am going to remove this mini split air conditioner from the wall. Before that, I will pump down the unit and recover the refrigerant, so it may not leak when I open the flare nut. First of all, you will have to check whether service mode is present in your air conditioner or not. If the service mode is present in your air conditioner, then it's easier to start the unit and recover the refrigerant. So, to check the service mode in this unit, I will remove this cover to get access inside it. After removing this cover, you will have to find the service button in your air conditioner. In different air conditioner brands and models, the service button can be in a different shape. If you normally look here, you won't find it easily. But as we know it, let me show you. The service button in this air conditioner is present beneath this. The air conditioner is off, but its plug is inserted into the electric outlet. Always operate the air conditioner in service mode in off condition, not in on condition, as service mode won't work when the display is already turned on. I will now press the service button for 5 to 10 seconds. A beep sound came out of it. The display shows an 18 degree temperature. It has turned on in cool mode. I will now go to the outdoor unit and check if it is starting or not. Now I have come out, and the outdoor unit has started to operate. Fan motor is also operating. The compressor of this unit has also started to work. But for knowing that I will touch this smaller pipe, this pipe should be chilled. If the pipe is chilled and working fine, then it means that you can recover the refrigerant in your outdoor unit. But if it is not cooling, then check the bigger or the suction pipe. If it is hot, I will tell you another method for that. But this unit is cooling fine right now. Now we have confirmed that this air conditioner unit has service mode. I will now turn off this unit. It has been turned off. The first thing that I checked is that this unit has the service mode. So now I will remove the hex cap nut from the service valve. I will now install the hose of the manifold gauge with the service valve. A tiny amount of refrigerant will come out, don't worry about that. Now I will purge the air out from the pipe I installed. When we install the hose with the service valve, it traps air. I did it so that no air would go inside the unit. I will now turn on the service mode, which I told you about earlier. The unit has started to operate. The outdoor unit has also started to operate. The service mode will turn on for 5 to 15 minutes. The different brands keep different timing for their air conditioner. You will have to recover the refrigerant at this time. I will now remove these dead nuts installed on the service valve. These hex Allen keys are used to open and close these valves. The 5-number Allen key will be used in this air conditioner. I will first close the smaller valve, known as the discharge valve. As I will close the valve, the gauge needle will start to go down. This means the unit has started to pump down the refrigerant in the outdoor unit. The gauge needle has started to move down. I will get ready to close the other valve. The refrigerant has stored in the compressor. The needle of the gauge is on the zero. Now I will start to close the suction valve. When you close this valve, you will need to turn off the unit immediately, to prevent the compressor from running for a longer period of time. The valve has been closed. Now this unit will be shifted to another place. Do tight the safety caps on the valve if you have them. If not, then use electric tape to cover the valves, to prevent any kind of dirt from going inside the valves. If any particles go inside it, then it could cause issues. These valves have been secured now. I will cover these pipes as well with electric tape. I am doing it so, because we have to reuse these pipes when this air conditioner will be installed in another place. If your air conditioner works both on heat and cool mode, then it should have a service mode, but if your air conditioner has no service mode or it is not working in your air conditioner, then I will tell you what method to use to start your air conditioner in winter. This method will also be applied to air conditioners, which are only cool models. I will demonstrate to you on this unit, which I have kept on the table. I will open the hood from the top of the air conditioner. You will see a thermistor installed in your air conditioner. In this air conditioner unit, the thermistor or the room temperature sensor is installed here, and it is yellow in color. I will remove it outward from its lock. In different air conditioning units, it can be mounted in different positions. So you will have to check according to your air conditioner. In most of the units nowadays, it is fitted on the top, right here. And in some units, it is installed here on the corner of the air conditioner. You can see these cuts made here. It is installed over here. Then, for that, you will have to open the complete cover to follow the procedure that I am going to show you. After removing the sensor from its place, hold the sensor in your hands. This thermistor will start to get hot due to the body temperature. But if you are working alone on the unit to recover the refrigerant, take some water in a glass. The temperature of the water should be between 30 to 25 degrees. As I am having it, the temperature of the water is 30 degrees. Then, take a piece of tissue paper or a piece of cloth. Let me tell you what you have to do with it. I will dip this tissue in lukewarm water. Now, I will squeeze the water out of the tissue. I just wanted to make the tissue warmer. Now I will wrap the tissue on the thermistor. In the end, I will secure it with a rubber band. Now, this way, your hands will be free, and if you are alone working on the unit, you will not need any other person to help you out. After this, you will have to turn on the unit with the remote. You will have to start the unit in cool mode. The outdoor unit will also start working because you just tricked the thermistor into thinking that the ambient temperature is warmer. But now, if the outdoor unit still has not started, you must come to the outdoor unit. If the backside of the outdoor unit is easily accessible to you, then it is very good. If not, then remove the top cover. After removing the cover, you will see the outdoor ambient thermistor. This sensor is mounted at the back with the clip inside the fins. I will do the same with this thermistor as well. I will wrap the warm tissue or cloth on it to trick it so that it may sense the ambient temperature is warmer. Now, after doing this, it is 100% guaranteed that your outdoor air conditioning unit will start no matter how cold the weather is. In a duration of 5 minutes, you will be able to recover the refrigerant in your air conditioner. I will now tell you the third method. This will be useful if you are trying to recover the refrigerant in winter. I will remove the front cover of the outdoor unit. After removing the cover, you can now access the circuit board. You will have to target the solenoid valve installed in the unit. But in this solenoid valve as well, you will have to target this coil here. The coil installed in this unit is black in color. A wire is also attached to the coil, which is moving upward and is connected to the circuit board. This wire is attached in different positions in different units. When you have traced the connector position of the coil, push its lock inward and remove the connector from the circuit board. After doing this, you will have to start the unit in heat mode. The outdoor and indoor units will start to work. The outdoor will only work in cool mode. We have just disabled the reversing valve and its mechanism so it would not operate in heat mode. You can easily restore the gas with the procedure I told you at the start in 5 minutes. If you want to recover the refrigerant in the summer, just start the unit in cool mode. As the ambient temperature will be high, you will have to apply the same procedure that I told you at the start. You will not have to take extra measures in the summer. Now, if you have no gauge but want to recover the refrigerant in your air conditioner, you can still recover the refrigerant in your air conditioner. You have to follow the same procedure but without the gauge. So, if you have a 1 or 1.5 ton unit, close the discharge valve first after the compressor has been started. Then, you must count to 20 if it's a 1 or 1.5 ton unit. Until you count to 20, the compressor will store the refrigerant, and then you will have to close the suction line valve and immediately disconnected it from the power. And this is how you will recover the refrigerant without the gauge. But if your unit is 2 or 4 tons, then, count to 30 after closing the discharge line, and then close the suction line. Cut the power off immediately, and this is how easily you will recover refrigerant in any air conditioning unit. If you are willing to support the channel, you can buy me coffee, for that visit Patreon. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos, and subscribe. Thank you.